What I would like is to have a program delivered to me every night with bios of the audience. Huh? Because then we would start out even. Where they live, last play they saw, favorite color, sexual preference, last relationship they screwed up.
You gotta stay up on a bronc for 8 seconds. Otherwise that ride don't count. So from that day on, my daddy called me Big Eight.
Anyway, they were all talking about municipal bonds or something, and we were just sitting around the TV with the pretzel mix. Jenny, Alan, Marty, Turk, Jack, and me. And I went to Oz. I was in trouble. I was being rescued from a whirlpool by an orc, a four-legged, four-winged bird with a propeller tail, and
we were, I'm sure, the last of our generation to save ourselves for marriage. We had 2 children. First a girl, then a boy, 2 job transfers, 2 homes, 2 subdivisions. And then, on our 15th anniversary, Arthur left me.
When I told Wally about the tests and how I still wanted it, he just... he just touched my arm and he said, "Sure." And then he smiled. The most beautiful, unforced, miraculous, heartful, beautiful smile.
Oh, they're so.
Did you love Kit with that?
It's the writing so
good. So good. Yeah, and there's such a story behind every one of those women.
That's yeah. So good.
You're not just saying that, are you?
No,
you have to use your friends.
I keep thinking, oh God, this is going to be.
Ain't much of a show. Not like snakes. Data does fire, but I can't do it. Pour some kerosene in a Coke bottle, sticks a rag in the top, lights it up, holds that fire under his chin, pass it down the arm, sticks his hand in it, you know, that kind of stuff. He says there's people do blow torches down Tennessee. I don't know. Jamie gave it a try before he went for Detroit. Just about burned his ass off.
I climb up to the brow of the hill, burdened with my troubles, hurting under my load. I see that yellow horseshoe like part of a rainbow, and it gives my old spirit a lift. McDonald's. I could spend all day in a McDonald's. I've done it, too.
And just go out and be there. Let's see what happens.
Okay.
You know? Forget about the plan that you had in your head. Forget all that. Mm-hmm. Just start it and see what happens.
Okay.
I can tell you almost 100% it's all going to be there and you're not going to have to think about it.
Okay. Thank you.
Okay. We'd sit with her after dinner and talk about issues. She told us she was too far gone for gossip or what we ate for lunch. Then we'd all turn in, and in a little while, just before I'd drift off, I'd hear this.
It was so great. Yeah, each one of the stories, you know, like, oh yes, like, you know, like,
Yeah?
Yeah. I really like them touching.
Oh, great.
Yeah. And I laughed.
Yeah. Is any of them your favorite?
Well, my favorite is that with tattoos, a marked life.
Oh, the marks life.
Yeah. That one was my favorite. She's really good.
Yes.
And the last one, you know,
the lamps.
The lamps, you know, when she, like, waiting for extinguish and then, you know, open.
Cool.
That way, Oh, wow. Yeah.
That's great. I'm glad you liked it.
Let's see here for my, can you hear me? Can you? No? Yes? You are out there, right?
Some of these are from family and friends. And my son. And my husband.
What did you think?
I thought it was fantastic. It was absolutely fantastic. I was moved. I'm still reeling from it, frankly.
And was there anything in particular that hit you?
The stories and the acting.
Is there anyone that you like, any favorite, or you think they were all
Gosh, a favorite? I think that would be a personal thing.
Okay.
Yeah, so they were all awesome.
So they hit you in a personal
way? Well, the ones that's funny is that some of them hit me really deeply, and my wife was marginally impacted, and then perhaps the other way around. There were some that I was just kind of waiting, and I turned over and she's bawling. So it's clearly a very personal,
wonderful.
Yeah, it was great. It's fantastic. Yeah.
Well, I've heard you say that when theater is done well, there's nothing like it. It just can't even compare.
You can't compare the experience.
Well, I mean,
I always go back. For colored girls who've committed suicide, when the rainbow is enough. There was a woman, Trezana Beverly, who did this monologue in the end. And just her on the stage, nothing else, about a woman whose boyfriend had originally raped her and then he went off to jail and she has two kids by him and then he comes and he wants her to come back to him. And she plays all characters. She plays him, she plays the kids, she plays herself.
Right.
So she's begging him. He comes back and he says, you know, hey, I can be a good daddy. I can be somebody. And she says, just go away. I don't want you in my life. I don't want you here. And then he grabs one of the kids and he starts bouncing it on his knee. And he says, hey, see, I can be a good daddy. And she says, you let that kid go. You let that kid go. And finally, he grabs both kids and he says, and he holds them out the window. And he says, are you going to take me back? Are you going to take me back? And she says, yeah, Daddy. Yeah, I'm going to take you back. And he drops both kids out the window. And all Trezana Beverly did was open her hands, and 700 people screamed. 700 people screamed. She had you so in that space, in that apartment, just her on a blank stage. Mm-hmm. That's theater.
Is it because you're sitting in front of a real human being right in front of you, and because they're good at what they're doing, there's a suspension of disbelief. You believe that is the character who she's saying
she is. Well, it's all about catharsis. It's catharsis. You are her. You're in that situation. She pulls you on the stage.
And that just doesn't work with film.
It doesn't work with film. It doesn't happen in film that way.
Because maybe in film, it's not a real person. It's not a live human being. So you're kind
there's
of
a separation.
Separation.
There's
right.
a screen and there's you.
Right.
But it's a different story when you're breathing the same air as the audience.
Yeah.
It's a different thing. You know, when I saw early on Macbeth with Judi Dench and Ian McKellen in London, years ago at the Young Vic at that time. And they were young at that time. He was like 28, she was like 26, whatever. The most electric Macbeth I have ever seen. And there was nothing on the stage. It was a bare light bulb. That was the set. And there were little boxes in a circle around it. And what they did with that bare light bulb and what they created, they forced you to become part of this. It's like they grabbed you by the throat and they wouldn't let go. And she was amazing. She was just amazing. That's theater. You know, you can't put that in a film. You're never going to get that experience in a film.
I think people just haven't experienced that.
They haven't.
You know, so
they haven't.
And because they haven't experienced, they don't know that that's what theater can do. So they don't bother going to the theater.
You know, they see so much bad theater.
Yeah.
They see so much dead, badly acted, bad theater. I mean, when you have an experience, like when after I saw Tristan and Beverly, I went, that's the kind of theater I want to do. I want to make 700 people scream just by opening my hands. I want that.
Yeah.
I want that experience.
Yeah. Well, these women approach that.
They do.
Piece.
Well, there's some pieces in here where you actually can hear people gasp.
Yeah.
They want to turn your pleasure into the ice damn capes.
I stood horrified and somewhat embarrassed at sea in the midst of asphalt, staring at drops of blood on my...
Yeah.
And in some of the pieces, you can hear a pin drop.
Yeah, yeah.
It isn't like, you know, I sit in the back of theaters a lot. And I can always tell by head movement and body movement if they're engaged or not.
Yeah.
Mostly throughout this entire play, there isn't a single movement.
Yeah.
Everybody is fixated on the stage.
Yeah.
There's no uncomfortableness, there's no uneasiness, no scratching the back of their necks. You know, they're with it. You know, and there's tears and there's sadness and there's, mm-hmm. you know, and it's a collective experience for them. So, yeah, there's moments in this that approach that.
Yeah.
That approach that kind of symbiotic kind of catharsis that happens when you're really on stage with them and feeling what they're feeling and going through what they're going through.